Hi everybody, so today I am doing something a bit different for you all. I'm going to do an overview and review of the Cambridge Satchel. First of all, I should start by saying that I am going to be showing you two satchels in two different sizes, and I'm going to be talking a bit more about the bags themselves and the sizing, and yeah, I hope you enjoy it. I think this probably would be quite helpful if you were thinking about buying a Cambridge satchel, because when I was looking to compare the bigger size to the smaller size that I've got, I couldn't really find any videos on what you could put in them, so I thought I would kind of tell you what you can put in them. So first of all, I'm going to show you my smaller of the two bags, which is this lovely one here. This is the 11 inch in Oxblood, and as you can see, it's a beautiful colour. I absolutely love it. This is slightly different to the other one I've got, but I will explain both of them in a minute. So this bag is obviously it's complete leather, and it's got the kind of strap attached to the side, and then this bit here is black, so there's no colour rubbing off onto you. You've got the Cambridge Satchel logo on the back. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that, but it's on the back. And you've got the two buckles at the front, and then this pouch here. So as you can see, the bag inside is black. Normally I can just put my phone inside that. I actually have the iPhone 6 now, and that goes in the front pocket perfectly, so that's good. I've got not much in my bag at the moment, and that's because I've not been at work. I've been really unwell recently, so I haven't got much left in my bag. I've only just got my purse really, but just to give you a bit of an idea, you can fit in with ease a purse of this size. This is my purse that I've got, and you can fit that in absolutely fine. I've just got my prescription receipt and my receipt from when I bought my prescription in there, and I've got a pen randomly. But just to give you a bit of an idea, normally I would carry my purse, which is just that as big as it is, my umbrella, which is a little travel umbrella. I've got a pouch with headphones and my iPod in them. My phone goes in the front, my keys go in the main pocket, and if I wanted to, I could also put my iPad mini in there as well. So it's a great size overall. You can fit your iPad mini in there. Whether or not you'll be able to fit a big iPad in, I don't think you would, in all honesty, but I've got an iPad mini, and or you could have a Kindle that will go in it as well. I think it's a great size for every day, and it's probably out of the two, I would say it's my favourite. I think it's more compact, and it means I don't carry around crap. And in all honesty, you know, the bigger the bag, the more likely you are just to chuck stuff in it. And you can't really do that with this one, which is why I like it. Also, just to mention that all the bags are quite structured. The leather does get softer over time, especially the buckles. And on the strap, you can adjust it. It's got quite a few holes, as you can see, and you can adjust it so that you can put it over your shoulder or put it as a crossbody bag. It's quite versatile, really. They're such great quality, and I absolutely love them. And I've had this since September, and I've worn it every day since. And yeah, I absolutely love it, especially this time of year. I think it goes with everything. So I'm going to put that down and get my bigger bag for you. When they actually come in this like dust bag here, and this is the bigger bag of the two. So I'm just gonna get it out, if I can. There we go. Right, this is the bigger bag. This is the Cambridge Satchel. I feel like it's taking up the whole of my head. This is the Cambridge Satchel 13 inch in black. Again, silver hardware. That other one's has silver hardware as well. I don't really like gold hardware, although I do have one bag that I absolutely love that has gold hardware, but never mind. So again, it's got a big pocket on the front. The main difference is it's got one of these kind of card holders here. So if you wanted to put some a card through there, you could. I've not done that personally, but it's quite a nice touch. Again, you've got the two buckles. And inside here, I actually used to have, I've got a bag organiser. It doesn't fit in my 11 inch, but it fits in my 13 inch. And you can just buy these from eBay. They're really handy. And again, you can fit the world in this bag. It is quite deep, I don't think you're really going to be able to see that, but it is quite deep. Although these are structure bags, you can still fit everything in. I can fit everything in that I want in both of them. If I was to go away for a weekend, I'd probably take this one, or I'd take that one and then another. I'd take this one and then another bag. It just depends on the situation. But since I've had my red one, my black one hasn't had a look in. So yeah, that's not really a what's in my bag, because you didn't really see much of what was in my bag. But it kind of gives you an oversight as to what the quality is like, because they are such great quality. I've had this one since September and that one for a year in September. And yeah, I absolutely love them. Size difference, obviously there is a couple of inches between the two of them. That's the main size difference there. They're not that much. I mean, that's not much difference size-wise. For some reason, a funny story is that when I went to look for the little Cambridge satchels, I saw the mini ones and I thought, crikey, they can't be the 11-inch. Of course they're not the 11-inch, Alison. Of course they're not. I was just like, how are they 11-inch? They're not. They're the mini ones, the tiny little things that are about yay big. They're really, really bizarre. As far as the Cambridge Satchel Company goes, they are amazing. If you've got any queries or any problems, then you can tweet them or email them, and they're great, great customer service. I would definitely say, if you're looking to get one of the satchels, then I would highly recommend it. I would definitely say to ask the Cambridge Satchel Company if there's a particular product that you want to be able to fit into this bag. When I was looking for the reviews of the 11-inch and I couldn't find if the iPad Mini would fit in it, a lot of people were saying, oh, the 13-inch is much better because you can fit all this stuff in it. And I tweeted them and I said, can you fit in the iPad Mini, the 11-inch? And they were like, yeah, there shouldn't be a problem. And they're right, there is no problem. So when I went on holiday, I took it with me and there was absolutely no problem. Yeah, I'm really happy with both of them. I think they're both great bags, and they're very sturdy as well. The leather on them is amazing quality. So I would definitely say that they're worth the money. They're not overly expensive. I think this one's around £110 and this one's not £100. They vary in prices, because when this one was actually bought for me, it was £105, and then within a week it went down to £99, so I was a bit confused. So they seem to vary in price, and they seem to like go, they have quite good offers on them and quite good deals and quite good sales on them and stuff like that, and they come in an array of colours, so good luck choosing a colour. I'm quite, not simple, that's not the word. I like to have a black handbag, that's probably my favourite. But when I was choosing my little one, I kind of thought, well, navy's too much like black, so what's the next best thing? Oxblood. And yeah, if you look on the Cambridge Satchel website, you're going to see a more detailed sort of like picture, if you like, of the handbags. And you can also see inside of them, so you can see which colour on the inside of the strap is. So obviously on the inside of the black strap, it's black. And on the inside of the Oxford strap, it's black. On some of them, it's the colour of the bag, it's on the strap. And I know people that have said that when they've got like the bright red bag, the red strap has kind of rubbed off a little bit. So just to make you aware of that as well. They fare really well in rain. I walk to work every day, 2 mile trip, and they fare really well in all weathers, and I'm so, so pleased with them. So like I said, if you are thinking about buying one, highly recommend them, and yeah, they're great value for money. So I hope you enjoyed this brief overview, and I'll be up there all really soon. Bye.